From students, in today's class, we are going to learn about the bacterial industry and its mechanism that is involved in bacterial germination and sporulation. As we all know, bacteria exists in two forms depending upon the environmental condition. In its favorable condition, it is present in a vegetative phase, whereas when the condition changes unfavorably, it switches into a endospore, whereas this endospore has the ability to resist it against the unfavorable condition. Then we have to look at the endospore in detail. What exactly is the bacterial endospore? It is produced by few bacteria where they are capable of using endospores, which means spore-forming bacteria. The best example would be Bacillus and Clostridium. Doesn't only broad-shaped bacteria can produce endospore, also cockle can produce endospore. This production of the capability of a bacteria to produce endospore will enable them to survive under an unfavorable condition like heat or drought or UV radiation, gamma rays, chemicals, disinfectants, desiccation can be tolerated. It is believed that an endospore can survive in the soil or in the water for years together and return into a vegetative phase onset of favorable condition, and that's its viability. Always, spore-forming bacteria is believed to be more pathogenic in nature because they are. It is very hard to get rid of them. Also, they have their own economical importance, where they are highly used in food industry. They are used in microbiology, like medical microbiology, and it is also used in industrial purposes. The simple difference between an endospore and an exospore: endospore is what is produced inside the bacteria, whereas the exospore, onset of unfavorable condition, the spore is produced outside the bacteria as far as exospore, and the endospore is produced within the bacteria. And to speak about its position where the endospore will be produced, the air is believed to be of so many types. It is not only in a particular place endospore will be present. It is present in the subterminal condition or in the terminal condition. It can be round or oval shaped. Here you can see a round subterminal, round central, oval central, oval subterminal, round terminal, and oval terminal. This tree will cause bulging of the bacteria when the endospore is produced. To speak about the structure or the outer structure of the endospore, this is a typical structure of the endospore. Here you can see different layers in which the endospore is produced, the multi-layer and more resistant. Here, the first layer, that is the light pinkish color, is believed to be the exosporium, which is believed to be a flaccid, delicate layer of or the outermost layer of the endospore. And then comes the dark pinkish color, which is known as the spore coat. This spore coat is believed to be just below the exosporium, and its function is highly beneficial. There are three important characteristics of the spore coat that has to be mentioned. The first one is believed to be its composition, where it is mainly made up of several types of proteins, or layers of proteins are present. And the next point is it checks the permeability of the spore. Here the permeability of the spore is being maintained by the spore coat, which means it will not allow any toxic materials to enter inside the spore, making it highly resistant to any sort of chemical disinfectants. And the third one is it is containing the highly important enzymes which will enable the germination of the endospore onset of favorable condition. So these three important characteristics of the spore coat means the very important part of the endospore structure. Next up, we have the cortex, which is believed to rotate more. This cortex is believed to contain a more volume or more surface in the sphere. Here you have the cortex, which is highly made up of a peptidoglycan layer. A strong layer of peptidoglycan is present, which when compared to the vegetative cell. The higher the cross linking, the more rigid, the more resistant will be the endosperm. And then now we have the spore cell wall or the core wall. This is the major important part of the endosperm, which is contained, which is surrounded by the protoplast around it. This is usually believed to contain the ribosomes or the nucleoids in its metabolically inactive state. When the metabolism of these ribosomes or the nucleoids have been ceased, on the favorable condition, they become metabolically active. Here we have the composition of the dry weight of the spore is believed to be the picolonic acid and the function around is not indicating the highly resistant to nature. Also, the DNA of the bacteria is being safeguarded by the acid soluble DNA binding proteins, which will enable the DNA to resist against heat, radiation, desiccation, and some many types of chemicals. This is the chemical formula for the chemical structure of the picolonic acid, and the a diagrammatic representation of how an endospore is being formed. This is a vegetative cell. All set of favorable condition, endospore is formed. That should be clear. And now here you have the replication of the DNA that is happening, which is contributing its content for the formation of the spore. Here there is a spore that is getting developed or that is getting mature, which means that there is a spore for formation. After the complete maturation of the endosperm, the bacterial cell wall ruptures, the endosperm is liberated free. Then, which onset of favorable condition on a suitable substrate will germinate and gain its viability. So, there are stages in which the endospores are being formed, which is nothing but the sporogenesis or sporulation process. Here you have the bacterial cell whose DNA will be replicated, which is contributing its genetic information to the spore, and the spore sector will be formed. That is the axial filament that is being protruded within or inside the cell to create as a separate section for the spores to be formed. Here, this a process of the plasma membrane starts getting surrounded against the DNA, which means a distinguished separate type of structure is being produced here, and this spore septum is being surrounded and isolated, which means the protospore is being formed, or the protospore is being formed, which means the premature form of spore that is being developed with two membranes. Now, a thick layer of peptidoglycan layer is being produced, which contributes to the maturation of the endospore. After the spore coat is being formed, it is being liberated inside the end membrane. This more clearly depicts how the bacterial cell gets converted to a super resistant form against the environment. Also, we should notice that as the DNA, as the endospore is being developed, the bacterial cell on its own is getting degenerated. This is the reason how a vegetative cell cannot withstand a high environmental condition or harsh environmental condition, whereas the endospore is capable of withstanding the high harsh environmental condition. When I have to speak about the sporulation, germination comes 1900. After the sporulation process, onset of favorable condition or the suitable media is obtained, the spores starts germinating, which means its metabolic activity is being regained. The metabolism will resume back. They were never destroyed. The genetic material still holds all the genetic information to metabolize itself on certain favorable condition. Also, we saw that there are certain enzymes in an active form which will contribute to germination process. And here now we have this germination process of endosperm, which contains the three stages, whereas the activation is nothing but the peptide sensing the favorable conditions in the environment, and then we have the germination process where we have a lot of germinating enzymes which will enable the enzyme activation and start metabolically activating the nucleotides, the ribosomes or the cytoplasmic contents that are present inside the spore. And here we have the output. This is nothing but the typical germination or the growth of the bacteria, or to show its viability, at which means it can start reproducing. The major important metabolic or morphological changes that's happening inside the endosperm is nothing but the swelling of the spore, rupturing of the spore coat, and losing its resistance to any sort of heat or other stress, environmental stress factors. It loses its ability to be rigid and becomes flexible, so that it can start producing. And this release of the spore contents are seen on retaining their metabolic activity back, which means it is now started utilizing the nutrients that are present around it, and also now it starts its outgrowth process. So this is the composition of all the membrane layers that I told, which is the exosporium, is made up of carbohydrates, proteins, and lipids, and expansion. And the spore coat, which is made up of again proteins, which is cross linked with the disulfide bonds. Then the cortex, as we all know, is made up of peptidoglycan layer, germ cell wall, exoskeleton layer. The inner wall is usually made up of a similar composition, just like the others. And the core is made up of the bacterial ribosomes, bacterial nucleus, RNAs, enzymes, acid, soluble DNA binding proteins. So all these are present in the core. And the presence or the function of it is really depicted in this one tabular column. So as I have spoken about the endoscope, how is it different from the normal scope? Why should we not use endospore and spore as a synonym? The difference is clearly depicted here. The spore is nothing but a minute, one typical cell structure, which is usually produced without sexual reproduction, usually in case of fungi. But when I say about the endospore, it is believed to be present inside the bacteria, which is produced on sector. Unfavorable conditions for you, whereas the spores is nothing but the form of asexual reproduction. Again, this is also usually produced in case of sexual or asexual reproduction, but there is only in the unfavorable condition. This is produced by meiosis. Spores are produced by meiosis because it is the endospore is formed by the replicated DNA using the spore cell. And this is nothing but the reproductive cell. This is the non-reproductive cell of the dormant cell. The spore is several types of spores are formed. One single fungi can produce thousands of spores, whereas the endospore one bacteria can produce only one endospore. The spore as well is basically produced by fungi and also by some bacteria. But when I say endospore, it is produced by bacteria on its own, and typical bacteria like bacillus or clostridium are only involved in the production of endospore. Now again, the difference between the endospore and the exospore has to be clearly understood. The endospores are the ones which are produced by clostridium and bacillus, whereas the exospores are produced by actinobacteria or actinomycin, so which are nothing but intermediate between the bacteria and fungi. Now we have the endospore, which is produced inside the vegetative cell, whereas exospore is produced outside the vegetative cell. Now the endospore is formed by the bacteria, whereas exospore is an asexual spore that gets separated from the mother cell. And it is believed that even after the exospores are produced, the mother cell is highly viable. But whereas in the endospore, after the endospore development, the mother cell is destroyed. Cell division is not involved in the formation of endospore, whereas here in exospore, cell division plays a major role. Endospores are released by rupturing the mother cell, which is where the exospores are liberated by budding process. Only one endospore can be produced in case of endospore production. Here, several exospores can be produced by simple bacteria. And these are the examples for which the endosporin exospores are produced. So this differences some alternatives, understand the concepts easily. And this video again will enable us to learn more about or to make the supporting notes for this lecture that we have taken. So see you all in the next lecture. Thank you so much.